What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. So today, as you can see, I'm doing a Selena inspired makeup, hair, and outfit video for you guys. The first part of the video is going to be in English, and then the second part of this video is going to be in Spanish. Bien rápido, les quería decir a los que hablan español que la segunda mitad del video va a ser en español. So si no quieren mirar esta parte en inglés, abajo voy a tener en donde empieza la segunda parte. Like many people out there, Selena has been a very, very big part of me, especially growing up. I've watched her movie 1001 times, and it makes me cry every single time while I was filming this video. Right now I'm even getting like choked up, but while I was filming this video, I was listening to her music and I was just like, oh my god, like it makes me cry every single time. But I've been wanting to do this video for a very, very long time because a lot of people have told me that I kind of resemble Selena, but I was kind of waiting for the right time. And I think today was perfect because it's October 1st and today is the launch of the Selena line at MAC. And then it is also the start of October, which means Halloween is this month. And if you want to dress up as Selena, then here you go. This video is dedicated to Selena and her family, and may she rest in peace. I hope you guys enjoy this video, and let's go ahead and get started. So for this look, I'm starting off with the base, and I'm starting with my Dr. Brandt Pores No More Primer. This is just going to smooth out any pores, and it's going to give us a flawless canvas. For my foundation, I'm using the Urban Decay All Nighter Foundation in the shade 5.0. This is a matte foundation, and Selena always had a very matte finish to her face. Initially, this foundation does look very light, but once it oxidizes and it sets, it gets a little bit darker. And to conceal and highlight underneath the eyes, I'm using my Bare Minerals Concealer. And then I also put some down the center of my nose to kind of brighten up my nose a little bit and bring it out. To blend out my concealer, I'm using my Beauty Blender, and I did run this underneath the sink so it is dampened. I'm using my Laura Mercier translucent powder to set my entire face. As I mentioned earlier, she did have a very matte finish. So to smooth out my face even more and to really get a matte finish, I just put this all over the face, including underneath the eyes. And while the powder was setting, I went in with my Benefit Hoola bronzer and kind of contoured my nose a little bit. So I contoured the side, I contoured kind of right above the tip of my nose just to give the illusion that it's a little bit lifted. For the brows, I did go in with a dark pencil to darken up my brow hairs a little bit, and in the inner part of the brow I carved them out, that way they're a little more circular in the inner part. And then I did bring the eyebrow product a little further out because my eyebrows are a little bit shorter, so I made them a little longer on the outer part. And then to bronze and contour, I'm using the Benefit Hoola bronzer again. In the picture that I used for reference, it did look like she had a little bit of blush on. So I'm using the MAC blush in Sun Bask. It is more of a bronzy blush, but it does have a slight rosy hint to it. For my lashes, I'm using a very wispy pair. These are a lot more wispy towards the end, which is exactly what I wanted. And then for the lip color, I went with the NYX Liquid Suede. I didn't want to go with the red that was too dark, so I decided to use more of a cherry red. And these don't dry up to a completely matte finish, which I feel like Selena didn't have a really matte finish. She did have a little bit more of a glossy hint to her lips. And of course, you got to put on some hoops because it wouldn't be Selena without the hoops. And then I did change out my top as well. And then for the hair, I feel like this is one of the biggest like parts besides the red lip. So all I'm doing is sectioning my hair into two. I'm clipping in extensions on the bottom half of my hair. And then on the top part of my hair, I have a full tutorial on this, but all I did was put my hair up into a ponytail, and then I wrapped my extensions around the ponytail to kind of cover up my natural hair and make it seem as if I have long hair.
And so that you can't see the tracks, I just go in with a little chunk of hair and wrap it around the tracks. And then for the rest of my hair, all I did was curl it with a 1-inch curling wand, I think it is. And I just threw on a little bit of hairspray, teased it a little bit, and that was really all that I did. For my outfit, I used a men's white collared shirt. I found this one at Goodwill. It was only $3.50. Some high-waisted jeans and the hoop earrings. And that's everything that I did to achieve my Serena-inspired makeup, hair, and outfit. I hope you all enjoyed this video. I love you guys, and I will see you on my next one.